Good morning, Wisconsin. Morning, world. It's a new day. Thanks for kicking it off with us here at Mornings on WFHR, Friday edition. Let them know, Marvin. It's going to be a good show, going to be a good day, everybody. Got your host, James J. behind the mic. I am joined by our head of production, our co-host, Seth Habhegger.
Good morning.
And the best listeners in radio. Thanks for joining us, everybody. Hope you're having a good one out there. We got great things lined up for you today. The El Cafe Birthday and Anniversary Club is right around the corner. Looking
awesome.
Forward to jumping into that one. We got Friday, Saturday, Sunday birthdays to celebrate. All that coming up. Crocs for dogs.
Or more Croc stories. Okay.
Yep, that's all we got right there. That's coming up. We'll be getting into that one. Looking forward to it. I got some other fun stuff to get into as well in this 9 o'clock hour. How much is too much content? We'll be getting into that one.
I may have some thoughts on that.
We have not only the El Cafe Birthday and Anniversary Club, but we also got Culver's Star of the Day coming up today. I got a fun one where Seth and I are going to play a famous TV theme song. Mm-hmm. You call up, get the answer right, you win some free Culver's.
Yes, indeed.
Just like that.
Easy peasy.
Want to kick things off reminding everybody that the Rapids Revival Downtown Master Plan community engagement event, the final one of these in-person events, is going on right now.
Mm-hmm.
Go join our friends at From the Ground Up Coffee Shop at 250 West Grand Avenue, right here in Wisconsin Rapids. Not only are they hosting this event, but they are the sponsors of the Sunrise Show on 105.5 WIRI.
That is correct.
We appreciate them supporting local, buying local.
Yep.
We encourage you to do the same. Get over there, support those that support us, and let your voice be heard about this, it's a really cool revival plan that's going on.
Yes.
A lot of communities will just do this. We got an idea. Yep. We brought in like 20 consultants from Texas and California and Florida and all this.
Right.
And you guys tell people what in Wisconsin Rapids what they like.
Yeah. Right.
The city is doing this so smart and looking out and reaching out to people. You need to meet them halfway and let them know your ideas.
Exactly.
You can't just sit there on your couch, eating bonbons like Peggy Bundy and yelling at your radio or your TV. I want this. No, you got to let them know. Get on over there, let them know, online or in person. Online, you can go to wirapids.org, and you will find the master plan link right there for that. Go ahead and sign up. And again, be a part of the community engagement event going on today about the Rapids Revival, happening from 8 to 10 over at From the Ground Up Coffee Shop. I imagine that in one ear, you can have your headphones listening to us.
Yes, you can.
In the other ear, you can go
if you listen to them, because that won't confuse you at all. You
or know? Or you can check out our podcast later.
That's it.
Either way, you can do that. And speaking of things you can check out, everybody, I want to remind everyone that we have our new Civic Media newsletter that is all going.
It's going as of yesterday. First issue. Premier issue, number one, collector's item. Well, I don't know about that.
Yes, yeah. If you don't have issue number one, really.
I'm telling you.
And I don't know if the others are going to make sense. You got to read the first one. Shout out to everybody with all the hard work on this one.
Yes.
Special shout out to Melissa Kay. You're really, really taking the initiative on this one and
really
running with the ball.
Yep.
We appreciate
true team that. Effort with with a lot of the folks around here.
Because the work that Laura's put in on this and our tech team and our engineers and everybody that are working so hard on this one. Sage, our owner, and the work he's put in on this.
Yeah, of all things.
We encourage you to sign up for this newsletter. This is your newsletter, everybody. We have designed this and made this specifically for Wisconsin Rapids, for Central Wisconsin.
Yep.
It is going to be doing our weather, our sports, our entertainment, our news, what's going on right here.
Yep.
We've got some of the better reporters in the state working for us in this right here in this city, in this Central Wisconsin.
Yep.
We're going to be able to highlight a lot of that and really highlight you. Because, again, this is for you. This is about you.
Yeah.
Go to WFHR.com. Sign up for the newsletter.
Yep.
I had not realized I hadn't.
Oh, no.
I did.
Get on that, man.
I did yesterday away. Right. And I'm just being honest with everybody because I'm all excited. And Melissa's letting us know, hey, newsletter's coming out. Let us know when it's coming and everything. And I'm waiting and I'm waiting. I'm like, wait a minute.
Why am I not seeing this?
I thought I did. I wanted to work on this with everybody. I wanted to be a part of this. And I'm busy trying to create content and not realizing I didn't sign up. So it's completely understandable if you didn't either out there.
Yep.
Go to WFHR.com, sign up for the newsletter. Could not be easier. Just takes you a couple seconds. seconds. Yep. Just putting in your name, your email, and you'll be right. You'll get it. You know, when we release them on a weekly basis, I believe. And
take a look at the one we just put out. It'll give you a good idea of where we're going with this, what we're going to be covering and everything. And I'm sure there'll be tweaks along the way, of course. But that's the main gist.
Those tweaks may involve your feedback. Let us know what you think of the newsletter and everything. We'd love to hear from you about this. And again, support us as we support this community.
Yep.
And sign up for that newsletter, everybody. I wanted to touch up on this one right here, Seth, because some parents love to go trick-or-treating.
Yes.
I know that this was something I enjoyed doing with my brother and sister, doing my kids. It's a blast.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. At the same time, some of us get stuck at home, you know, handing out the candy. One of the parents or one of the, you know, somebody watched.
Which can be fun in its own way, of course, too.
Absolutely. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I've been doing this for about 6 or 7 years, handing out candy, and I love it. I get such a kick out. I actually feel like it's one of the better gigs on Halloween. You just sit there, and all the costumes come to you.
They come to you, and you get to check them out. Yeah,
it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. You get to hand out big life-size candy bars and stuff, and feel like a big man. Here's a real candy bar. There you go. You know, it's great. It feels good. But what if you're torn?
Uh-oh.
What if you want to do both?
Oh, that's a challenge.
We have a solution.
Oh, okay.
There is a solution online that's going viral called the trick-or-treatable costume. This is one that you are going to have to make at home, but I think that is a good thing.
Yeah, I agree.
It's a costume that turns you into a Halloween candy bowl.
Jeez.
So you can walk around with your kids and be a mobile candy dispensary all along the way.
He's got a visual image, an image of what that would look like. Oh, my God.
This is one of the
exactly what I thought.
Yes.
Yes.
It is pretty much what you're picturing in your head, everybody. Now, this person has M&Ms and Kit Kats, it looks like.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a woman. She's got a bowl around her with suspenders holding the bowl up.
Yep.
And she has a great color scheme with Twix and, you know, looks like peanut M&Ms, it looks like.
There you go, yes.
Or Reese's. Maybe they're Reese's. I don't know.
You know, she's really close. And you know, the way the picture is, she could put like something on her head and she could go still as a thing.
Yeah.
Like if she put like a wick on her head, she could go like a candelabra or something.
Yeah.
That would work, or something similar. You know what I mean? So you could still have fun with it, even though it's just a bowl around your waist.
You could be a bowl of cereal. and hand out like Rice Krispie treats and stuff.
See, that would be clever.
Oh, and then and you're handing out Rice Krispie treats.
Yeah,
so it's a cereal
perfect.
Type of thing.
Perfect.
I like
that.
That's a good one. That's a fun idea. So there are instructions online for how to make it. Basically, you find some kind of big beverage bucket or plastic kiddie pool or something like that. Mm-hmm. Cut a hole in the bottom big enough for you to get inside.
Right.
Spray paint it with the color and design you want of your human candy dish. Then you attach shoulder straps so you can pull up the quote bowl like suspenders, and you cover the inside of the with bubble wrap so that it closes all the gaps comfortably. Oh, I didn't think of that part. That's good.
Of course, yeah.
The bubble wrap.
You're really spilling it out, you know.
Yeah. The bubble wrap will also keep the candy away from, you know, bumping up against you and all that and everything.
Exactly.
That could be good. There is no word here on how much of the candy you will lose to your own children.
Yes, or yourself, for that matter.
Maybe
having snacks on the way, you know, when you're moving.
My father wouldn't make it out of the house. Would not make it. Like, this is the greatest idea ever.
Yeah. He's going to think it's for sitting at the couch, right? It's this is awesome.
Boy, Dad, that's going to be great when you're walking around. What? Walking around?
What do you mean?
What? I ain't leaving nowhere. Got monk on. I'm watching this.
You know, it would be mean. You could go as a garbage can and just have candy wrappers in it.
Oh, that's great. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's a good prank.
Or you could have like a mix of both. So they're like, oh, no, here you go. Oh, but sorry, you got the wrapper. But the other kid gets, oh, here's a candy bar.
You let them choose. I like that. I like that. You let them pick out of there. That's good. I think you could have a lot of fun with this one. This seems like a great idea, especially if you're sitting out there and you're like, man, I gotta come up with a costume. I haven't come up with anything yet. I think that's fun.
Yes.
I'm all for, you know, last year when everybody was dressing up as Barbie or you know, the different things. But what I really enjoy is the creativity of this day.
Absolutely.
There's nothing wrong with dressing up as Dracula.
No, not at all.
Or anything like that. But the people, like last year, that were dressing up as Barbenheimer, where they were like JD's, you know, they were like JD Oppenheimer.
Yeah, right.
Like Barbie version or you know, the combinations. I like the combination one. Or the original ideas like this. This is original. I think this is a pretty fun
Very
idea.
Very cool.
I say all that, and I'm dressing up as Jack Skellington. So I'm not even doing anything, you know, original myself. I don't know.
There's nothing wrong with, you know, if you put a little thought into it and, you know, and a little effort, it can come out really nice.
I think I did. And like some Jack costumes, they don't have what I will. I have my own Zero. I have a Zero. I have Zero to go along
with
Jack.
That's right, you do.
It just came in the mail yesterday.
Oh, gosh.
It is a stuffed Zero.
Okay, yep.
It's not real, but it might as well be to me. I did not realize how badly I want a dog.
Oh,
I had no idea.
Goodness.
I got this thing for the costume, and I figure, well, you know, when I'm not using it, my mom can have it as a decoration with all of her Halloween decorations.
Right.
And so I set it out. And then I'm like, I don't want it out there. I want it near me. I want it by me. And I picked it up and brought it into my room.
I want
it
here.
And had it nearby.
Yeah.
And I haven't, I'm not sure if Sam likes it. I'm not sure Sam likes it much.
Competition.
Yeah,
he may not
yeah,
like that.
Yeah,
he may not.
I don't think he's a big fan of that. But I did not realize how bad I am with this, man.
Or maybe he wants to play with it. It's not doing anything. Like, come on. What's going on, guy? Why aren't you talking to me?
Yeah. We're going to be talking Halloween costumes more a little bit later. And certainly on Monday, when Melissa joins us, we're going to be getting into different Halloween costume ideas for this year.
Love
and some of that. We're also going to be talking a little bit more of Halloween jack-o'-lanterns and stuff and jack-o'-lantern ideas. We want those from you, everybody. We'll be getting into that a little bit later today as well. We got tons of fun stuff coming up in the 9 o'clock hour. But first, we got to get to the El Cafe Birthday and Anniversary Club. And a little after that, we will have our star of the day with our friends from Culver's.
Ooh, good stuff.
All that coming up right here on The Morning Show at WFHR. It's time to do some celebrating with our great friends over at El Cafe. We encourage you to treat yourself. Get on over there right now, 221 Market Avenue in beautiful Port Edwards. Wish them a great day from all of us here at WFHR. Keep in mind, they got some Friday specials that are going on over there, and their Friday night fish fry menu is going from 10:30 a.m. to 8 p.m.
Nice.
This is their late night, everybody.
Late night, everyone.
Late night at El Cafe. It's a good time. Go ahead and head on over there. Check it out anytime.
Prime time after prime time.
Yes, I love it. That prime rib and prime time. Enjoy some great food over at El Cafe and say hi to the gang over there for us, everybody. We appreciate them. Great stuff going on all weekend long over there. We encourage you to get us your birthdays and anniversaries. Let us know. We want to hear from you. 715-424-2600. You can, of course, call up on the Civic Media app as well.
That's right.
Direct message us through Facebook, email us, all of the above. We want to hear from you, everybody.
We do.
We've got to celebrate not just today, but Saturday and Sunday birthdays. Looking forward to that. On Saturday and Sunday, we've already got our qualifiers.
Okay.
So we just need a 1 through 3 from you, Seth.
I was rolling up my sleeves. I thought I had work to do.
All
okay.
right, yeah.
Let's do 3 today.
Okay, gives us that qualifier. Get right into the celebrating. And first up, we want to wish a very happy birthday to Richard Casper.
Happy birthday, Richard.
I apologize, Richard. Casper threw me off of Halloween. Casper, I can't imagine.
Nice.
I got to think that I'm not the first one to bring that up.
I'm sure this time of year they hear it quite a bit.
Yeah.
Yes.
Richard, enjoy your day. Hope it's a good one for you, sir. We wish a very happy 10th anniversary, to good friends of ours here, Al and Patty Carsey.
All right, Al and Patty.
They work over at Right Way Cleaning Services, which keeps our office beautifully cleaned.
They do.
We appreciate them. Do amazing work here. If you need cleaning cleaners, go to Right Way Cleaning.
That's right. They will take care of you very well.
They've been working with us for many years.
Yes,
and
they have.
We are radio people. We could be messy. They do an amazing job.
Picking up after
us. Yeah, they're really great over there. Happy 10th, Al and Patty.
Yeah.
And happy 44th to our qualifiers, Tom and Janet Gaber.
Oh, Tom and Janet. Congratulations.
44.
Nice.
That is impressive. Nice.
Getting into
done,
those. Getting into the nice long years here.
Congratulations to you both. We take a look at Saturday where we wish a happy birthday to Pam's brother-in-law, Jim Hilke.
Oh, happy birthday, Jim.
Great guy.
Tomorrow?
Great guy, great name, great person. Enjoy your day, Jim. Hope it's a good one for you. We wish you a great one. And on Saturday, we also wish a happy birthday to one of our own and just came into the building
into the building here to walk in. Timing is perfect.
Laura Berg, celebrating the birthday
happy birthday,
on Saturday.
Laura.
Wishing you a great day, Laura.
Yeah.
A wonderful creative. Yes. Like one of the more creative human beings I have met, an incredible mother, incredible colleague, wonderful human being that we are very, very happy and proud to work with alongside and be a part of this team. I want to wish her a great day.
I was trying to see how much more awkward I could make it. Yeah.
That's not fair. I was trying to make it awkward for you, but you don't get awkward.
You don't reverse.
Nicely done. And happy birthday, Laura. Enjoy your day.
Nice.
We wish you a good one. And, of course, we wish a happy birthday to our qualifier on Saturday, Gene Drewiski.
Oh, happy birthday, Gene.
Enjoy your day, Gene. Hope it's a good
one for you.
Wishing you a good day.
Mm-hmm.
And on Sunday, we have a one anniversary to celebrate, or one person persons to celebrate.
Okay.
Celebrating their 17th anniversary.
Nice.
Jacob and Katie Johnson.
Jacob and Katie.
Enjoy your day.
Enjoy your day. Have a good one.
Congratulations to you guys.
Yeah.
And congratulations to all of our qualifiers. Mm-hmm. Brag to your friends, family, animals, strangers that you are qualifiers for the El Cafe Birthday and Anniversary Club.
A qualifier.
Yeah.
I'm a qualifier.
Let them know. Let them know, everybody. We take a look at our celebrity birthdays for this weekend, starting with today, of course. And Cardi B is 32.
Wow.
Hmm.
32?
She's one of the more popular artists out there.
She is.
Pretty darn good, too, from what I've heard.
I've not had a lot of... I know who she is.
Mm-hmm.
It's not a lot of experience with her music. That's
she's
all.
Pretty good.
Yep.
Michelle Wie is 35. She's very good.
Wow.
LPGA golfer who retired with $6.8 million in career earnings.
Not bad.
She was one of the bigger names in golf for a little while there.
When she was young, she was the phenom, right?
Yeah.
And she had so much... probably too much... Exposure when she was like in her teens, which seems like a bit much. Man, I hate doing that to kids that young, putting so much weight on their shoulders so early.
I wonder if that's why at 35 she's retired.
I think that is part of it.
I know that health might have had some to do with it. I seem to remember something about that, but I also think the public eye. And you've already made $6.8 million.
You're good.
You're doing all right. Michelle Trachtenberg is 39.
Mm.
Dawn on Buffy the Vampire Slayer and Georgina on Gossip Girl.
That's right.
I remember her. She's a good actor.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here. Emily Deschanel is 48. Dr. Temperance on Bones.
Yep.
She's, of course, the older sister of Zoe Deschanel.
That's right.
I've seen them do some interviews and some things together. Not surprising, but very good chemistry.
Yeah.
They seem to really get along
really,
really
good. By the way, she's also in one of my favorite memes of all time.
Oh.
The Spider-Man.
Yes.
The original Spider-Man Pizza Time.
Yes, yes.
This meme that goes around all that, pizza time.
So good.
And she's the one that at the desk, yes.
Yeah, yeah. Jane Krakowski is 56.
Oh, my gosh.
Jacqueline on The Unbreakable Kimmy Schmidt.
Yep.
Elaine on Ellie McBeal. But many of us know her as Jenna Maroney on 30 Rock.
Man, has she had a great career.
Yeah.
She's been on, like, three iconic shows. So good.
When 30 Rock was first being created, Rachel Dratch was supposed to be in that role.
Oh, wow.
There were talks of Amy Poehler possibly being in it, but Amy Poehler was working on another show, Parks and Rec.
Yeah.
It was in development at the time.
Right.
That was going to happen. Rachel Dratch wasn't able to make it work with scheduling and I think some contract stuff.
Mm.
So Jane Krakowski came in, and I honestly didn't know how that was going to go over or anything. Perfect.
She killed it.
She was perfect.
Yep.
Did an amazing job. let's see here. Joan Cusack is 62.
Oh, love her.
Former SNL cast member, some might forget that. Sheila Gallagher on Shameless. Jessie on Toy Story. She is, for Nick's 16 Candles, you'll remember her from.
Yes.
Just a wonderful actress and just as good as her brother. And that's saying something,
yes.
I think.
Also, by the way, if you have kids of a certain age, she was the narrator of a little show called Peep in the Big Wide World.
Oh,
This children's show that I think it came out of Canada, but she was the narrator for it, storyteller.
I can only imagine a fantastic narrator with that voice.
Yes.
God, I love her
voice. Great
voice. She's got a great voice. I mentioned this before on John Cusack's birthday. Gross Point Blank. I believe it's the only movie you get to see those two work together in.
Mm-hmm.
They're so good in it. But if you're looking for a sneaky good Joan Cusack movie, Toys.
Mm.
Joan Cusack, Robin Williams, they play brother and sister, and their chemistry is phenomenal. They are so good together.
She is good in that.
I just thinking of scenes, and it gives me goosebumps.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a fun movie. It's not a great movie, but it's a fun movie. If you're just looking for a fun watch, Toys is a great one.
There's another movie that John and Joan are in together, but I don't believe they share any scenes together
because
it's a kind of an ensemble film, Cradle Will Rock.
Oh, my God.
That's a great Tim Robbins
incredible.
Film.
Yeah. Tim Robbins, man. He knocked good director. Get out with that one. That's the one for me. Of all the Tim Robbins movies, I forgot about that movie. That's a great one.
Excellent movie.
It's a really good one. Steve Young is 63 today. He was really good. Retired 49ers quarterback, MVP of Super Bowl 29. Brigham Young's great-great-great-grandson. Interesting.
Same name. Yep. Yep.
My second favorite quarterback growing up. I loved Randall Cunningham and I liked Steve Young. Mm-hmm. I liked those running quarterbacks. I didn't get to see a lot of that back in the day. Now
back
they
in
all
the day.
Run.
Now they all. Well, they try to.
Yeah, but it's very true. I remember watching Steve Young play, and he takes this massive hit, and it had to have been like a Monday night. It was a big game because Madden was calling it, and Madden and some are all going back and forth, I believe, and one of them brings up that he was a graduated attorney.
Like
the top of his class and everything. Like incredible mind when it comes to that stuff, and chose to play football.
Yep.
Like, you know, like he didn't have to play football. Could have made a great living as
being,
an attorney,
being a lawyer. Yeah.
But love the game.
Yep.
Daryl Hall is 78 of Hall and Oates, of course.
Woo!
A lot of great hits for those guys over the years. And we look at people no longer with us, like Luke Perry passed away on this, or born on this day in 1966, passed away in 2019.
Mm-hmm.
Younger people out there will know him from Riverdale. Older people like us will know him from Beverly Hills 90210.
Yep.
And a good guy.
Yes.
Like one of those guys that where so many actors have these egos and so many different things. Luke Perry never shied away from taking a shot at himself.
Mm-hmm.
He did some cameos on The Simpsons where he did he was Krusty's son. Or no, he was going to be the new sidekick Mel, Sideshow Mel. He was looking for a job after 902 or whatever.
Yeah.
And he was going to be his Krusty's sidekick.
That's right.
Like,
I
did some
that.
Great stuff as just in cameos and things, I think. The great, the wonderful Eleanor Roosevelt, born in this day in 1884, passed away in 1962, social reformer, humanitarian, FDR's wife, served four terms, which makes her the longest serving first lady.
Of course, yeah.
And I believe the biggest game changer when it came to being the first lady. Everything changed after Eleanor.
Yes. There's no doubt about that. Yeah.
If you knew or read anything about Eleanor Roosevelt, and I encourage you to if you haven't, I did a biography on her when I was in school as a kid. Her and FDR, both the Roosevelts, actually. I'm a Roosevelt guy.
Yeah, right.
Those are two of my, when it comes to politics, those are some of my people. I the good, the bad, all of the above.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
They tell the story of America in the Roosevelts. And with Eleanor, you have somebody who was never going to just sit there. Like, she wasn't just going to be sitting there and waving. She was going to do something with that position. She was going to do something good with it.
And she did.
And now every first lady has a cause. Every first lady has something that an initiative that they take on and they want to help the country with.
Right. I mean, even when she was first lady and even after she was FDR had passed and she was no longer first lady, she had a syndicated newspaper column.
It's so cool.
Wow. It's really cool.
And where did that, and where that came from, the idea for that, because it's not
as if
everybody was doing that.
Right.
It's not like nowadays, she's going to have a podcast.
Yep.
It was pretty impressive.
And by the way, very influential. And even after FDR had passed away in the Democratic Party, she was very influential.
Very.
Yep.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Mm-hmm.
H.J. Hines also celebrating a birthday today, born in 1844, the ketchup king.
57 flavors.
Took him 56 tries to get to that 57th. Taking a quick look at Saturday birthdays for you, everybody. Let's see here. Kirk Cameron is 54 on Saturday.
All right.
Mike Seaver on Growing Pains, of course.
Mm-hmm.
The great Hugh Jackman is 56 on Saturday.
Wow.
Laura, you share a birthday with Wolverine.
That's
pretty cool.
I just gotta put that in
pretty
there.
Cool. That's pretty cool.
I'm more excited about Cardi B.
Nice. She's more excited about
Cardi B.
The audience could hear. That's a good one. Sam Moore is 89, Hall of Famer, R&B legend of Sam and Dave.
Oh, love Sam. One of my favorite acts of all time.
Mm-hmm.
Love those guys.
And the legend, Dick Gregory, born on Saturday, 1932, passed away in 27.
She also shares a birthday with Dick Gregory.
How
cool is that?
The legend.
Yeah.
We have no Pryor, no Murphy, no Lawrence, no Rock. None of these guys. None of these guys without Dick Gregory. Jackie Mason would tell you there's no Jackie Mason without Dick Gregory. There's so many comedians that really got the chance to do different work because of Dick Gregory.
You know, there was a couple of people that comedians that started with the current events kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
And before him was Mort Saul, of course. He was probably the most famous that did that. But he was the one that really brought it up to talk about things that people didn't want to talk about. And he brought him up, and he was very bold about what he said.
Just incredible. Incredible mm-hmm. performer. I encourage you to go ahead and look up some Dick Gregory if you haven't yep. heard him before. And while you're at it, go ahead and listen to one of the greatest voices you'll ever hear, Luciano Pavarotti. Would have been celebrating a birthday on Saturday.
Okay.
Nicely done. Born in 1935, passed away in 2007. I mean, if somebody told me that was the greatest voice they ever heard, I would not argue.
I would believe it.
Yeah.
I would believe it.
Incredible. Mm-hmm. Obviously, the three tenors mm-hmm. And the work they did. Imagine that. Three opera singers get together, put out an album, and it does well.
And it does amazingly well. Like, it was like legendary. A blockbuster.
We say three tenors, and most people out there know exactly what
exactly.
we're talking about.
Yeah. That's worldwide.
That's really
worldwide.
I don't think I ever really thought about that before.
And the time that it was released when, you know, like, classical music, opera is dead, you know, that kind of thing. Yeah. No, it's not.
Yeah.
No, it's not.
Still the greatest version of Ave Maria I've ever heard.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
On Sunday, celebrating birthdays, Sacha Baron Cohen is 53. Very versatile actor.
Yes, he is.
Very versatile actor.
When he's not being overly silly.
Yeah,
which is one of the reasons that I like.
I'm not a fan of jerk comedy, and a lot of that is what he does.
Yeah.
And at the same time, man, you see him in like the Chicago 6 or the movie that he did on HBO mm-hmm. where he's playing the famous attorney and stuff, and some of the work that the serious work he does, and my God, he's good.
He's actually quite good.
He's really talented.
He is.
I don't mind him as a comedian, but I kind of enjoy his serious work a little bit more than his comedy.
I'm with you 100%.
Just because his comedy doesn't hit me. It's not my thing.
Nope.
Nancy Kerrigan is 55 on Sunday.
Oh, legend.
Legend. It was so much fun to watch on the ice. And
because she was so tall. You know, that was for me one of the things, because no other skaters were like, she was like giant up there. And
she
did amazing things. It was really cool. Yeah.
the greatest receiver I've ever seen, by far and away, Jerry Rice is 62 on Sunday. But even if I didn't say that, everybody else would. Because there's nobody.
You can't.
There's very few athletes where you can say, that was the greatest, and we all agree.
Mm-hmm.
You know? Even Michael Jordan, people are going to debate if LeBron or Wilt Chamberlain or any of these things. There is no denying Jerry Rice is the greatest wide receiver in NFL history. If you don't believe us, go ahead and look at the records, and then take a second and look down. Because everybody that is in second place is miles behind him.
Miles.
Receiving, touchdowns. I think Moss actually is up there in touchdowns, so receiving yards, yards per catch. There was never a receiver like Jerry Rice.
And if you ask receivers, they would probably tell you the same thing.
And one of the more influential guys to me off the field, actually. Mm-hmm. A bigger influence to me off the field than anything. He celebrates his birthday with Chris Carter, but not the receiver, the creator of X-Files.
There's a lot of Chris Carters out there, by the way, just to put up there. But yes,
Chris Carter,
that is hilarious.
That's kind of funny.
I love the idea.
That's celebrate.
Celebrate. Oh, not that Chris Carter.
Paul Simon is also 83 on Sunday.
Nice.
Got a big break thanks to Art Garfunkel.
Oh, you're going to get an angry message from Paul Simon. He doesn't even know why. He's just going to make
you. I don't know why I said that. I don't know why. People that would have been celebrating birthdays, Margaret Thatcher, born in 1925 on Sunday, British Prime Minister from 1979 to 1990.
Mm-hmm.
So much of our childhood, remember Margaret mm-hmm. Thatcher. And Lenny Bruce, born in 1925, passed away in 1966.
Wow.
One of the most groundbreaking comedians and entertainers of all time.
Speaking of groundbreaking comedians, this was a good weekend.
Dick Gregory and Lenny Bruce celebrating back-to-back birthdays. Mm-hmm. That is pretty cool.
Yep.
Thank you to El Cafe. We appreciate our friends over there and appreciate all of you getting us these birthdays and anniversaries. Have a great time and celebrate all weekend long, everybody.
Yes, indeed.
We'll be back after our news break with our star of the day from our friends from Culver's here at WFHR. Every time. It just hits me every time. Lights, camera, action. It is time to make somebody a star of the day with our friends from the Wisconsin Rapids Culver's. What Seth and I are about to do is what we do every Friday in this time slot. We play a famous TV theme song. If you haven't won anything in 30 days, all you have to do is know the name of the theme song,
mm-hmm.
call the TV show or something. Let's be honest. Get close. If you get close, we're going to give it to you.
We're good.
We want you to win, so get ready to call up. And call up and let us know, 715-424-2600, what TV theme song this is. You're going to win yourself a family pack of four from our Wisconsin Rapids Culver's. That's two adult meals. That's two kids meals. That's free Culver's.
That's awesome. I got to do a quick note before we do this because This one might be a little bit more difficult for some people because it wasn't like a classic show from back in the day. But I got to give James props on this one because he's taking one for the team here. He is. I'm kind of surprised he's doing this one. So
I wasn't too gung-ho about it. I'll be honest. I wasn't too well set. But
he's willing to do it. He's willing to do it.
I'm doing this for Wisconsin and I guess for my dad and my daughter.
There you go.
There's a tease, everybody. Get ready to call 715-424-2600. If you're listening on the Civic Media app, might have an extra jump ahead of people. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and get ready to dial up and let us know what TV theme song this is.
It's jungle out
what
there.
The?
Disorder and confusion.
Wow, I wonder if I should thank them. They called in right away. Well, good morning. What's your answer?
Monk?
Oh my gosh.
Oh my.
Amazing.
No. Whoa.
That was so good.
Whoa.
That was fabulous.
That was, and that. I think that may have been the fastest winner we've ever had.
I have never seen it that fast.
Yeah, yeah. Well done. Who do we have on the phone with us?
Jade Johnson.
Jade! Oh, I thought I recognized that voice. Jade, it's awesome. Nicely done by you, Jade.
Thank you.
Oh, well played. Mm-hmm. Now, did you get that one right away from the music or the tease?
Both.
Nice. Well done. God, that is such a you answer.
The keys, and then when I heard the first note, I'm like, yep, it's it.
That's got to be it. That's the confirmation you needed. Yep.
I love it. All the better. And I didn't have to play much of the theme song.
Which makes it even happier.
That's fantastic.
I was trying to save you.
You did a great job of that. Were you? Did you watch the show? Were you a fan of the show at all, Jade?
I loved Monk, yeah.
That's cool. That's very cool. Nice. Yeah, but I guarantee you it's probably what my dad is doing right now is watching reruns of Monk. That's how he starts his mornings.
Nice.
Of course, the theme song, that voice, Randy Newman, the legend Randy Newman. It's jungle out there. But the reason I chose this one is this week we celebrated Tony Shalhoub's birthday, October 9th. And, of course, he is Wisconsin's own Green Bay native.
That's right.
Tony Shalhoub, one of the more famous Green Bay natives. So we thought that'd be a fun way to celebrate. But we didn't know we'd get to hang out and talk to a friend. That's awesome. Jade, thank you so much for listening and playing along.
Thank you. Have a good day.
You too.
You too.
Jade knows where we're at, and we know her. She'll be able to get here and pick this up. We'll have it right at the front desk for you, Jade. Thank you so much for listening and playing along. That was fantastic. I appreciate the preface before that, Seth, because this one, I don't get it. I wholeheartedly admit.
First of all, it's Randy Newman, who is an artist, as far as I can tell, you don't understand at all.
Absolutely.
Which is just cool. You know, we've all got artists and musicians like, I don't get them. You know, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
That's all right. So already you got that. And then I love it, though. I'm glad you were willing to do it.
Well, this is okay. So here's the thing. And I hadn't really thought about what it is that bothers me other than Randy Newman.
Okay.
And I will preface this by saying Randy Newman is a million times more talented than me and has a lot more soul.
He's won Oscars for some of his scores.
He's won Oscars, for God's sake. Yeah. Please, Mr. Newman, I mean, no offense. Just not my thing.
Yep.
But it doesn't fit the show. I don't feel like it fits the show.
Right.
It doesn't seem to like... Now, what I wanted to do was...
Okay, all right.
And I bet Jade will remember this one. I wanted to actually play... where did it go? I had the original theme song.
Oh, I didn't know it had one before that.
The original... the original theme song was just a simple kind of... like a piano. Just a simple little piano interlude.
Which would make more sense... Okay, that's like a guitar, yeah.
Oh, guitar. No, you're right, it's a guitar. But this was the original theme song for Monk. And I don't know if it was just the pilot or whatever. A little side note about this one, this show actually almost never got made.
Mm.
It spent years in pre-production. Hmm. They could not find an actor to play this role. Every actor they tried, nobody could land this role.
Wow.
Tony Shalhoub gets done with Wings, and they're still trying to make this happen. They started when Wings was still around.
Mm-hmm.
And he's an out-of-work actor. He's not out of work, but he's looking for
his next project, right? Yeah.
And they just send a shout-out to him because USA, of course, carried Wings.
Mm-hmm.
And oftentimes networks will use actors they're familiar with.
Mm-hmm.
And they bring him in, and he's one of the last people they're going to interview for this gig. Yep. Otherwise, they're scrapping this. Monk's never going to happen. Monk is loosely based on a Sherlock Holmes story. And it kind of starts from there.
Okay.
And they're going to let it go until Tony showed up and just killed it. Just nailed the audition. And we have all these seasons of Monk and one of the better, more fun detectives in TV history. Let's take a phone call real quick. Good morning. You're on the show.
Hey, another song I just thought of that the song doesn't fit the show is Frasier.
Agreed. Agreed.
With
what's up with that?
Kelsey Grammer scatting at the thing.
I maintained
about tossed salads and scrambled eggs.
They were in contract negotiations with Kelsey Grammer, and they're like, hey, we want to do a spinoff of Cheers. Great. I wanted to sing the theme song. No. And then they finally went back to debate. Okay, fine. We'll do it. Fine. You can sing the theme song, Kelsey.
You're right. That's a very weird theme song.
Yeah.
That one always just kind of confused me. I don't know.
It's an interesting.
All right, guys, have a good one.
You too, man. You too. Thanks for the call. Thank you to Jade, our newest star of the day. We appreciate you, Jade. Thanks so much.
Yep.
And we send a gigantic thank you to our friends over at Culver's. Listen, every Friday in this time slot, you could be the next person winning some free Culver's and being our star of the day.
Yeah.
Be back, more fun in the morning show. Welcome back, everybody. Morning show here at WFHR. Serious comedy to start your day. Seth and James hanging out with you. Little Stevie to play us in, and the baddest bass line you will ever hear. Those horns kick in. That's when you know it's time. Like there is, if you go ahead and look up any version of Superstition Live, you will not see a bad version.
No.
Like, it is one of those songs where he just brought it, and he made sure that band brought it every time they did that song.
That's here you go, James. Totally apropos of nothing. If you had to choose, I mean, in Motown, you got Marvin, you got Stevie in the 70s. I couldn't do it. I could choose between them. It's too amazing what both of them did.
I'm going to take Marvin because I feel like he needs me more than Stevie does.
Oh, really?
Stevie's fan base is bigger, and I feel like that but I couldn't choose. Couldn't actually choose. I'm just trying to keep the conversation.
That string of albums that Stevie had, just amazing work.
That run he had.
Yes.
Incredible run. Mm-hmm. Few runs in music history like that one.
Amazing.
We've actually been talking a lot of Crocs this week, unintentionally.
for some reason.
I don't know why, but they've been coming up in the news a bit, and they're... there's a new one out that we're talking about. How about Crocs for your dogs?
Okay.
So Crocs for dogs. This is a real thing. They're like normal Crocs, but smaller, of course, and they come in a set of four. Like I really needed to explain that. There's a strap.
No, they're only for the front feet.
Yeah, they just come with one. There's a strap around the ankle so they won't slip off. They claim fans have been asking for dog Crocs for years, so they finally caved and went with it. Mm. They're already listed on the Crocs website for $50, but you can't buy them until October 23rd.
Okay.
They come in three sizes and two colors, green and pink. There's also a matching pair of for humans, so you can coordinate.
Of course, because that's what I want to do.
Oh, God. But colors glow in the dark, and October 23rd means you might get them in time for Halloween.
Oh, there you go.
So there you go. You can be in a lazy American costume, something like that. Speaking of, there's also...
Hawaiian shirt.
There you go. Let's go all in.
Yep.
They're also selling a new Crocs Halloween costume. That we are going to talk a little bit about on Monday. I want to get more into that.
But, all right.
There was one other thing about this that I wanted to get to because I was all set to make fun of this one, but I had forgotten about the first dog that I really I co-owned it with the girlfriend I had at the time that I was living with in Illinois. We had a dog, Gonzo. He was a little terrier guy, very cool dog. Mm-hmm. In DeKalb, we had like the worst of Madison and Chicago weather, and it just always seemed like it was always either raining or icy.
Mm-hmm.
And that dog had a hard time going out and going doing his thing and everything. So Joy thought of getting him booties, booties and stuff.
Yeah.
And my God, if you ever like putting shoes or a snowsuit on a child is one of the more difficult things you will ever
sure
do in
is.
Your life. Putting booties on a dog is right there, man. I will not say it is as hard, but it is in that ballpark. It is in that realm. That didn't last very long. And Gonzo just kind of like sucked it up, like a lot of dogs do.
You know, what's worse, the cold on the pads or having some weird thing that you're totally not any... Clothing on animals is just It's so foreign to them that it's like, what is this?
It's so much of how they sense and feel. Mm-hmm. Think about when you put gloves on and you can't just feel things really.
Right.
That's a big deal for
them. Right, or use your phone.
Right, exactly. Yeah. And you know, you don't want your dog not being able to text you. You don't want that.
You know.
But with this, I don't know. If this works, then this is the first time I've ever really been in favor of like Crocs and stuff because there are a lot of dogs that could probably use these. Mm-hmm. If they stay on, they're comfortable, they don't mind wearing them and everything. There are, you know, whether it's a hot blacktop on a 100-degree day or other things
or
like that.
Or ice or the opposite rain.
I could actually see a use for these. Mm-hmm. One of the problems of this is that's not why they did this. They did it so that, you know, humans can dress up their animals, which I just don't understand. Of all the disconnects I have with my fellow humans out there, this may be one of the bigger ones.
The desire to put clothes on an animal.
I admit that I find some of these costumes funny, or I find some of these things silly.
Or clever, yeah.
Back in the day when they put the cat's head through the bread, that was kind of funny. It's kind of funny. Right. There's some funny ones there.
Yeah.
But for the most part, it's incredibly selfish. It really is. Unless, of course, please correct me if I'm wrong, any animal has ever come up to you and said, "Yeah, I want to be a clown this year." Like, okay, then, okay, all right. Hey, Fido said he wanted to be a clown. All right, you can be a clown. Other than that, I don't see a reason for this one.
No.
I don't know if it's a real...
And they're more interested in trying to get your candy, actually, is what it
absolutely.
Is. So keep it away from them.
Yeah. I do like the people that do have the animal as a part of the family costume.
That's
see,
not
this
bad.
Is where I'm a hypocrite, because then I think it's very cool and I think it's very interesting.
If you can do it without putting him in a costume.
Yes.
Say you got like the kind of dog is like Toto from The Wizard of Oz.
Yeah.
And you want to be Dorothy. Perfect. You just carry, you know, your little dog with you and there you go.
It works out.
Don't have to put him in a costume.
Technology can make our lives easier, better, and more productive, but it can also be the bane of our existence. According to a new study, the average American says they lose about 3 days a month to digital content overconsumption.
Oh, wow.
Social media scrolling, as well as streaming and binging. So there is some TV show movie watching in there.
Exactly.
But it's not all scrolling, but still. That's more than 2 hours every day, and it comes to about 36 days per year.
Wow, that's a lot.
Keep in mind that it isn't all the content you're consuming. It's the content overload, the time you feel guilty about losing.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not so much, you know, just everybody, you know, kind of does that a little bit. It's doing it when you maybe feel guilty about not doing that and not doing other things.
Right.
Not surprisingly, young people lose more time than older folks. Gen Zers say that they lose closer to 5 days per month or 60 days per year.
Mm-hmm.
Overall, Americans consume about 6 hours of content per day, or about 7.5 days per month. Gen Zers devour closer to 7 hours per day and nearly 9 days per month.
Mm-hmm.
So,
okay.
What do you do with this data? It's to each their own. But I like to think that it's kind of an idea to give you an idea of and be aware of these things. If we're not aware of it, then we tend to not, you know, do much about things.
Right. I want to point out, everyone, that everything that James just listed there was all screen-related things. here in radio, we also produce what's called content. By the way, a word I really don't like, but I know we have. That's where we are right now.
Yeah.
But we're no screens here.
No.
No screens. You can enjoy listening while you're doing other things, you know, exercising. I'm telling you, this is better than just streaming, you know, binging, whatever. This is what you want to be. This is the content you want to be consuming right here.
Plus, how many other morning shows are covering the fun and interesting and very, very important topics of dog crocs?
I'm telling
nobody,
you.
Nobody.
No one.
Nobody but us.
And no
spread the word of radio, everybody.
That's right.
Specifically
it's
our show.
It's still, exactly. But just ours. No.
Yeah.
Not just radio in general. No. Just us. That's what we want.
Make sure to do that. Yeah. Download the Civ Media app. This is how, if there is anything in life that you're doing too much of, this is how you stop doing that. You first become aware of what you're doing.
Exactly. If it's something you want to change. Now, for me, staring at a screen too long just makes me feel weird.
Yeah.
You know, there's like a physical thing or that happened. At least that's what it feels like to me. I don't know if it's actually physical.
Mm-hmm.
So I've never been good at binging or TV. I can't do it. You know, I remember when I was, you know, younger, like a teen and early 20s, I would play like role-playing computer games. And those are, you know, very involved and are very long.
Mm-hmm.
And if I played it too long, I would get up and I'd just feel,
yes.
You know,
yes.
Staring at a screen too long, just, it makes me feel yucky. So I'm not really into that kind of thing. So
I actually think that, being the first generation of video games, at home video games.
Yeah, exactly. Yep.
Kind of like for some of our generation, it prepared us a little bit for this.
I think it's true. Yeah.
Where we are not attached to our screens, or at least understand that too much screen time and some of that. A lot of us that grew up being told, hey, don't stare at the TV too long, or standing too close to the TV, some of that stuff. And at the same time, of the issues I see with technology are our generation, are the older generations. The younger generations, I mean, they have their moments, sure, but they don't seem to be nearly as bad with some of this stuff as some.
You know what it is? I got a theory here, and I just thought of this, okay? Because the younger generations are used to streaming. Mm-hmm. And they can watch any show whenever they wanted to. What we're trying to do, our generation, is watch all the shows we couldn't do again unless there was reruns.
Yes.
We were limited. So now we have to catch up. We have to watch them again because we didn't get a chance to do it the first time around.
Well, and
we have to.
I agree. 100% think that's a really interesting point. It's also, where... When we were growing up, we were the last generation, really, of rewatching our parents' shows and their shows and the pair of shows they watched, reruns and watching old TV shows. We still did that. Now, not only is there so much content, but there's too much new stuff coming up. There's always new shows.
Yes.
There is no really for the major networks. There's a calendar season, but even that is a little skewed.
Yeah, right.
With summer
not like
programs.
It was. Yeah.
There's a lot of TV shows that only come out in the summer that are very popular. Stranger Things being one of the biggest ones.
There you go.
Things like that. That part of it has really thrown a monkey wrench into things too.
Yes.
It's just weird.
Changed. That's how things have changed. Yeah.
And I don't know, good, bad, what
happened. No, I don't know if it's Yeah, just put a moral judgment on it.
Yeah, I don't know about that, but I do know it's interesting.
Mm-hmm.
The Rapids Revival Downtown Master Plan Community Engagement event is going on right now. It'll be going until 10 o'clock over at From the Ground Up Coffee Shop at 250 West Grand Avenue, right here in Wisconsin Rapids. Let your voice be heard. Get on over there, let the community and let Kyle and the gang know your ideas and your thoughts about what we can do with these plans.
Yes.
You can find out more at wirapids.org, wirapids.org. You can also, if you're not able to attend the event, you can let your opinion be heard that way online.
Yep.
Otherwise, head on over there and thank the Ground Up Coffee Shop not only for supporting these events and hosting these, but also sponsoring things and working with us here at the stations. We appreciate them.
Good friends of ours. And plans? Plans are good.
Yes.
I think plans are very good.
It could be a controversial statement, but you know what? I like a person with a plan.
Plans
a good
good.
Plan. I'm a plan guy. We will be back for fun on the morning show here at WFHR.
This is locally grown radio. WFHR 1320 AM, W248.